Dina Diamond from Nanuet. My question is for either Mr. Sabatini or Mr. Gronak. For years, the Nanuet Mall has been going downhill. There are hardly any stores there. What's happening with the mall, and what's the final plan for it?
I can tell you from my viewpoint, since I'm not a politician, I'm outside of government, that the Nanuet Mall has reached the bottom of the hill. It's pretty much over. And I know plans are afoot to rebuild it. Some of those plans have been exposed publicly. I haven't seen them all. Alex may be able to give you a better answer on that.
Is a success story for the people of Clarksville. They have plans to demolish the mall. Hopefully they're going to start this November. In a perfect world, they'd like to be open in the year 2013. I think the real important news, though, about that is about the renewed confidence that business has in the town of Clarksville. Because Simon Company, Stop and Shop, U.S. Structural Steel, Kohl's, Lowe's up in Nanuet, they've all done major projects and countless more in the town of Clarkstown because of the record that we've achieved. The lowest taxes, stabilized government, money in the bank. So I think what you're going to see is a Nanuet Mall saying, and they are saying, we've got confidence in Clarkstown. That's why we're going to make hundreds of millions of dollars in investment. Simon doesn't do this without research. They research our community to death because they're not going to make that type of investment only to go bankrupt. So I think the good news is they've done the research and they said, we're going to go with a new Nanuet Mall because there's a new Clarkstown. We have confidence in Clarkstown. That's not me saying it. That's Simon, Stop and Shop, and a host of others. So it's really great news for the people of Clarkstown, great news for the Nanuet School District, and hopefully around October, November, that mall will start to come down. Sears and Macy's, if they do it right, will still be standing. Simon doesn't own them, and it'll create hundreds if not thousands of construction jobs, permanent jobs, and much to my chagrin, it will even produce a lot of sales tax for the County of Rockland, which we get very little of.